I'm Scott Hamilton, and I'm an associate professor and the coordinator of the civil engineering program.
You might have that much difference in the machining of a
piece. I took a kind of unusual path in that I was an Army officer. I went to West Point, and then I served in the Army for a little over 26 years. During that time, I had an opportunity as an assignment to teach civil engineering at the U.S. Military Academy at West Point, where I'd gone to school, and got hooked on teaching civil engineering.
Another strain gauge, but we orient it.
I think the most exciting thing about your college and civil engineering is that it's brand new. It really gives us a blank slate, so we can do what we think is right and what's going to be the best for the students. And, you know, it's going to give us an opportunity to do some things that are a little different, a little new.
And then, can I get a stress strain curve?
One of the big complaints of engineering is, well, how am I going to ever use this and all? So that's kind of how I treat every lesson, is I need to make sure that they see what they're doing has a relation and how it relates to the real world.
Strain curve, ah, so if I can get my stress strain curve.
When you're working with students, you get those times when you see they got it. Maybe they've struggled. Maybe it's a student who hasn't done all that well, but all of a sudden has taken it up a notch, taken it up a level. Or the student that's been struggling and then makes it over the line.
As opposed to just the length, and yeah, you could possibly do it.
It's a great age, they're figuring out who they are, they're looking for how they're gonna model their life, whether professional role models, personal role models, whatever. So it's just a dynamic time in their life, and to get to be a part of it for a little bit is pretty rewarding and exciting.